Hey everybody, and welcome back to another video from Upstart Epoxy, your number one source for high quality epoxy you can trust. My name is Steve, and in this episode, we're going to show you some basic mixing techniques when it comes to both deep pour and tabletop epoxy resins. Let's start off with deep pour. Remember, when you're using Upstart Epoxy's deep pour epoxy, it's always a 2-to-1 ratio. So that means two parts epoxy resin and one part hardener. The epoxy resin is usually in the orange container and the hardener is in the blue container. So you always want to put a 2-to-1 ratio of those so that they mix well together, and that way you achieve the results that you desire. You'll notice a big difference between deep pour epoxy and tabletop epoxy. Deep pour epoxy is a lot more watery because it takes it a lot longer to cure. It's a lot slower process, usually about 72 hours, and that's between 70 degrees and say 80 degrees. You'll notice when you're mixing the epoxy that it's a lot looser and it's almost like water compared to tabletop epoxy resin. A pro tip that I like to tell everybody is if you're going to be doing color pours with deep pour epoxy, it's okay to mix it with the mixer. You're going to get a lot of bubbles in there, but that's okay because the color will hide those bubbles. However, if you're doing like a two-stage pour where you're going to put a base of color and then you're going to go over it with another pour of deep pour epoxy that's just clear, I always recommend mixing by hand. It leaves a lot less bubbles, and it's not as hard for the epoxy to pop those bubbles that you don't always get when you use the heat gun. So that's kind of just a little pro tip that I want to throw in there for you folks. When you're mixing color, use that mixer. And if you're doing a clear layer, just mix it by hand. That way it's less bubbles, less pain, and less work for you, right? When mixing deep pour by hand, I always go nice and slow for about a good 5 to 10 minutes. Like I said, just to ensure that you don't have a lot of bubbles. Let's move on now and talk about tabletop epoxy. Tabletop epoxy is ideal for gloss type finishes. If you want to seal in your wood or if you want to seal your project that you're working on for life, I recommend that you use this. The best thing about doing this is it's a 1-to-1 ratio. So part A is 1 and part B is 1. Super simple. Doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure that. If you pour 3 ounces of part A, guess what? You're pouring 3 ounces of part B. You mix it up and you pour it. And the cool thing about tabletop epoxy is it's self-leveling. So it'll always give you a nice, clean, smooth, and crisp finish. Now, when I pour tabletop epoxy over a table or a board or something that has depth, like in this picture here, I like to mix it by hand, just like with deep pour. That way there's less bubbles and you don't gotta worry about seeing that. You can't really get everything with the heat gun. You gotta rely on the heat itself from the temperature of the room or the heat from the epoxy as it heats up to get those excess bubbles that you can't always see or get. So it's always a good rule of thumb if you're gonna be doing a layer like this to mix it by hand. If you're gonna be doing a color layer, just like with deep pour, I highly recommend you use a mixer. You'll definitely notice the difference between deep pour and tabletop epoxy. Deep pour is always gonna be a lot more watery and tabletop is always a lot thicker. You'll notice it, especially when you're mixing. Well, folks, that's it for this video. I hope we were able to help you out with any questions or give you some information that you didn't know about. Thanks again for watching this video. This is Steve, and we'll see you next time.